Welcome to Mega Man X. Yeah, I'm just gonna say that I wasn't going to do this initially. Because, well, this isn't what I wanted to do right away. I wanted to do something else. And problem with that game is it ran fine. It ran perfectly alright. I could play it. It'd be fine. Push the record button, it would immediately crash. So I'm sad. Started recording another game and it was like, eh, this isn't really, nah. It just came out to, nah. So I figured, screw it, I'll just do Mega Man X, and yeah, end up something to do, to fill in the time before I decide, because usually, when I'm recording like a decently long LP, like around 50 episodes, around 20, 30, maybe 40, I figured out, okay, I'm gonna record this next. And that kinda didn't, that happened, and then, you know, I went, oh, you can't record this because we hate you. I don't know, maybe I just needed, I don't know. It doesn't matter. Maybe in the future I'll figure out what's wrong with that. But anyway, if you don't know what Mega Man X is, the first one, I feel sorry for you. That seems a little extreme, but I mean it. I'm sorry. You're either too young to know it, your childhood sucked, or maybe you're just not interested in Mega Man at all. Huh. Personally, I used to play this game a lot. A ton, even. I'm talking, you know, a bunch of years ago, I beat this game in under an hour. Like, the whole thing. I didn't 100% it, no. I beat it in under an hour. From start to finish, I beat it. I didn't get everything, I think I only got like half of the stuff. Because that's all I needed. But, yeah. Shot needs to be X. Jump needs to be A. Otherwise it feels strange. No. Stop that. The failings of using analog and something that I should have a D-pad for. I don't know where my D-pad controller is, even. I wish I did. I'd much rather play this with a D-pad, because it feels weird with an analog stick. Like, anything PS1 and later feels fine with an analog stick. Old stuff like this? No, man, it doesn't feel right. Anyway, Mega Man X. Hopefully I don't fail too horribly, considering it's been a very long time since I've played. Although, I'm pretty sure I remember everything. No, that's not rapid fire, that's me pushing the button. Yeah. Come on. Ah, don't do that. Yeah, Mega Man X. Probably not in my mind better than Legends as far as, you know, my nostalgia factor. But definitely a game that's way up there. It really is. No. Now, at this point, I look screwed. Luckily, X can wall jump. Let me tell you, not knowing that, because, you know, you're a kid and you refuse to read instruction manuals because it somehow makes you, like, less of a man or something, is a little bit strange. Yeah. I think eventually I did get out of there, but I couldn't figure out how the wall jump happened. Later, it was like, I was really confused about it. Oh, usually you guys, instant die. Yeah, it took me a long time to get out of that first pit. A long time. This is why you should read manuals, kids. At least glance over them. You know, you don't have to read the, you know, absolute spoilerific story and whatnot, and blah blah blah, and read that and absolutely ruin parts of the game for yourself. Figure it out on your own. You should at least read the controls. Maybe there's something you don't know about. Although most games now have in-game intros, so it's not really a problem anymore. There was one more thing I wanted to talk about during this. Hell if I can remember what it was. Must have not been that important. Wow. Oh, just two? I was quite quick. Usually it's like five or six. I think it has something to do with the position of the ship. Oh, by the way, meet Vile. He is a jerk. He's quite vile. That's a terrible joke. It's not even a joke. By the way, completely unkillable. Like, you could cheat and still not beat him. Like, give yourself infinite energy and all that, and you can't kill him. Like, all the upgrades in the game, you cannot kill him. Worthless piece of scrap metal? That's not very nice. I'm Mega Man. Oh! Whole thing story about Mega Man. That's what I wanted to talk about. Mega Man X. In the intro, you read something you might have read if you were reading. X went under 30 years of careful, you know, tests to decide whether or not he'd break the first rule of robotics, whether or not, you know, you would harm a human being. All Reploids, which, you know, that's Vile, is based off of him. However, they didn't go through that 30 years of testing, that deep, deep testing, and I think in reproducing X, mistakes were made, and that's why Mavericks happened. That's my theory. That's what I'm thinking. So, you know, eventually mistakes lead to Mavericks, and Mavericks can break the first rule of that. So, yeah, and my sound just went up inexplicably. Yeah, and X is actually a pacifist. Yeah. Like, if you really look at all the history and all his decisions and what he wants to do, he only fights because he realizes that he absolutely has to. You know, because even though he's ancient technology, he still beats everybody up. He'd rather not fight at all. He'd much rather, I mean, for him, fighting is the last option. Also reminds me of the episode of the Mega Man cartoon where X was there. I mean, X was not designed to be a war machine. He was, you know, designed with the ability to defend himself and uphold justice and all that. But really, he's not, you know, he'd rather not fight at all. What button is it? B, okay. I always start out with Chill Penguin because, well, he's kind of a joke. And his stage gives a very important upgrade. It is much needed. Do 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 bunnies that hurt you. Also, I remember owning this game when I first got it. I couldn't beat anybody. Like, I could beat the stages, like get to the end. I couldn't actually beat any of the robot masters, as it were. And those guys laugh at you when they hurt you. I can't even discuss how irritating that is. But I had this game, I couldn't beat anybody. And, you know, I had a cousin who had a great many of the first Mega Man games. And I brought it up and wanted to see if he could beat it. And he went through one of the other stages, not this one. And let me tell you, he couldn't beat it either. Because one of the bosses, if you have his weakness, he is the easiest boss in the game. Like, ridiculously easy. Like, when I get to him, I'll beat him in about 12 seconds, give or take. However, if you don't have his weakness, he ends up being pretty much the hardest boss in the game. Yeah. It's one of those. Doo-doo-doo. So yeah, you gotta learn how to wall jump pretty early on in this game, otherwise you're pretty screwed. Because it makes you do it right at the start. Let me tell you, initially, when I first played this game, getting stuck in that hole for quite a long time, simply because I would not read the manual, is quite embarrassing. Since then, I've started to read manuals occasionally, unless it's an RPG, and then I don't see the point. Well, if it's an action RPG, I'll glance at the controls, but if it's an older game, you know? Not a newer game, there's no point, because they show you everything in-game. It's like, oh, you know, you're playing a shooter, press the trigger button on your right hand to shoot. Well, no crap. Most people are right-handed. That's what happens, you know? They would be holding a gun with the right hand on the trigger. Although, I'm right-hand dominant, and I'm right-handed like most of the population, but I'm actually left-eye dominant, so I have to actually shoot with my left hand on the trigger, which is really weird. It feels strange. I mean, if I shoot the other way, I can't hit anything. You know, back when I used to go to, like, shooting ranges and stuff, just, you know, target practice. It's all I really ever wanted to do. Occasionally we did that. Really weird feeling to get used to that when you're completely right-handed and it turns out all your right hand is now doing is a supportive role. Also, we have the power to dash, in case you've missed that. It's rather important. Another one of those enemies that laughs at you after it hurts you. Hate that. It's like, you bastard! Don't laugh at me! But yeah, Mega Man X, I could discuss so much, but it all happens in the later games. Story-wise. I mean, origins of, you know, like Zero, who, if you haven't noticed, doesn't have a sword in this game. At least none that I could see. I think he gets it in the, third one? In the hole you go! Oh, boy. Also, enemies now killing us with snowballs. They like to do that. Oh, extra life, thank you. I haven't gotten hit by a snowball yet. Usually that's the first thing to happen. But yeah, Mega Man X, fantastic game. Huge upgrade to the first Mega Man. And, you know, the dashing thing, which was completely new to me. Because at the time, I hadn't played the newer Mega Mans that had the slide. I mean, I was still trying to beat Mega Man 2. Which I suck at, to be perfectly honest. Don't get hit by that. You'll be frozen in ice. Also, if your lemons bounce off, jump on the wall. Of course, you know, the dashing thing, the jump, the wall climbing and the dash jump and all that, because you couldn't slide while you couldn't jump while you were sliding, really changed the design of the levels. Because, you know, if you put Mega Man X with his abilities into regular Mega Man levels, X would just wouldn't have a problem getting anywhere. He really wouldn't. No problem at all. yeah, don't get hit by that unless you like being a block of ice. Yeah, but Chill Penguin is pathetically easy. He really is. I usually come to this level first just for the boots. That's the only reason. His power-up, his weapon is used for someone much later in the order than I do. So, you know, that I go to that level for the boots. You could do it in a different order. I suppose you could do this guy first, but doing his level with and him without the boots is rather no. Just no, don't do it. No. No. Do. Also, best music in the game.
Yeah!
But yeah, I wasn't planning on doing this. This is, you know, last minute. I'm recording this an hour before it's going to go up. Simply because of, you know, the game I was going to play. Start pushing forward. The game I was going to play doesn't record. Anyway, you probably noticed that X's life bar is extremely small when you compare it to X, to regular Mega Man. That's how you fix it. There's one in each main level in the game. So, every robot master, I guess you want to call it. Mavericks. Maverick levels. Yeah, there's one in each level. That's how it is. I should remember where all of them are. Also, I usually think of this number as binary for 9 instead of 1001. I don't know, maybe I'm weird. Then again, you probably already realized that. I should be able to get all the power-ups in this level. Because there's 3. Energy tank! Energy tanks in Mega Man, you'd pick them up and use them, and then you'd never have them again. In X, you can refill them. At the moment, you know, it's more than a full heal. Later on, it's not quite a full heal. Yeah. No. This is bad. Get me off this button! Ah, crap. I thought he was going to die. Oops. Well, that's what I get. Can't say I don't deserve that. It's all in a rush and doing all kinds of things and just meh. There is stuff over to the right. Mostly just like life, power-ups and whatnot. It's not worth getting. Isn't this one of the musics I use in, based on, one of the source musics I used in a, remix for another video? Or something? I think it was Grandia Redux. Wasn't it? Oh, yeah, so it was Mega Man X Brain Sick Metal. Go download it. You should. It's important. Right now, go to OC Remix. .org, I think. Look up Mega Man X Brain Sick Metal. Do it now. Go get it. Now. You should. I mean it. No, really. Stop this video. Go download it. Listen to it. And listen to its awesomeness. Where did that guy go? I don't think I killed him. I haven't even used, what's-his-face's thing yet. Shoots that. You don't care. Come on. Yeah, I was going to play another game also, and I was thinking about it. And it's like, you know, I've never actually played this game before. And just maybe, I should get used to the controls a little bit. So let's play Mega Man X. I mean, way back in the day, I beat this game in under an hour. You know, which I think the world record is like 45 minutes or something. To my knowledge, I don't know. But, it's also one of the, this is one of those games that, I used to play on an emulator in Fast Forward. If you go in there, I think there's an extra life or something at the end of it, but it takes forever to kill those, thingies. Yeah, it's not really worth it. Yeah, I used to play this game a lot. I mean, for me, Mega Man X series held so much more importance to me than the regular Mega Man series. I'd be like, Mega Man, you know, 42. Mega Man X 2 must get! You know, that happened. I don't know. I think my main problem with how the regular Mega Man series went is just it became too cartoony, and X didn't do that. Also, it mentions that your head breaks bricks, but so does your wall jump. So, apparently, X also has heads in his feet, although I'm not sure how that would work. Oh, I want that. Also, do you remember all those falling platforms in the Mega Man games? Have some more. Yeah. Now, you can go down the ladder, but don't. You want to actually, you know, fall to your death, right? Oh, wait, there's power-ups. Don't fall to your death. Yeah, make sure you go get that. You might not need it, but I'd get it. Now, this is why I said you needed the dash boots. This guy's main tactic is to try to knock you off his platform. That's pretty much all he does. I mean, he does and can do damage. Nah. But most of the time, it's just trying to push you off his platform. And it's made a little bit easier by the boots. Also, don't accidentally run into him. Yeah, don't do that. I've done it before. It's painful. Shouldn't. I'm surprised he has. Oh, here he comes. Swooping. Do do do. I like to kill him while he's swooping. Nope. Yeah, this guy is a joke. once you have the dash boots, really. No, I want to kill you while you're swooping because it's a cooler ass way. Yeah. When I first played this game, and I started being able to beat him, I didn't even think of shooting him while he's swooping. And it actually ends up being a pretty long fight if you don't shoot him while he's swooping. Once you figure out how to, you know, the timing, he just falls like a stack of cards. Yeah, Storm Tornado. One of the more powerful weapons in the game. It is fantastic. That hits quite a few times, and most enemies it will murderify quite quickly. But that's enough of this. And next time, I'll be doing Flame Mammoth. And also, you can do this to see where they are, and you can see the specifications. See what they're called and all that. Yeah, we will be taking care of Flame Emma in the next part. So until then, this is not going to be a long LP, let me tell you. I mean, consider, let's think about it. Intro stage, and two bosses dead in first video. And most of the time I was just goofing around. I wasn't really, you know, driving at it. And I'm not going to, because it's Mega Man X, and instead of rushing through it like I used to, I'm just gonna enjoy it. Yes, until next time.